Hi guys, so in today's guide, we're gonna go through some of the basic customizations for the cookie solution using the visual configurator. Now, I'm on the homepage, the cookie solution landing page, and I'm just gonna click on start generating here to directly open up the configurator. If you're logged into your account, you can also access the configurator by just heading to your dashboard, clicking on your site area and going to cookie solution and add it. And if you are a completely new user, you can simply click on the start generating button from that page, from the cookie solution landing page, and it'll take you to this configurator. Now, we're in the configurator and right away you can see we have a couple of basic options. So really quickly, I'm going to add a website name here, mywebsite.com. And now if we wanted to change, let's say, the location of the banner just within the basic view, we can switch it from the top to the bottom. We can also slightly change sort of the look of that, so we can go from light to dark and custom, as well as we can have some control over our content collection options. And right here we have a couple of options. I'm going to go through them really quickly before we get into the other customizations. Now, the first one is prior blocking and asynchronous reactivation, and you want to have this selected in most cases unless you are running cookies that are exempt from the consent requirement, and in most cases the cookies you're running will not be exempt. Strictly speaking, the only cookies that are exempt are technical cookies necessary for the functioning of the site. To be safe, I would say always have this one clicked. The prior blocking and asynchronous reactivation is really important, that you get consent, valid consent where necessary, before running cookie scripts. Now, in terms of prior blocking, it's not simply a case of clicking this and then all of the cookies will be blocked. You will need to set up a blocking mechanism on the back end, and we have several guides dedicated to that. You have a lot of options on how to do that, and you can find those guides really easily within our help section of the site. Now, onto the second point, we do have different browsing options, content options in relation to browsing. Now, for example, the Italian data authority allows consent by scrolling or by continued browsing. It's considered active consent. However, various member states might have slight changes here in regards to what they allow and what they don't allow. By and large, throughout Europe, based on past cases, consent on scroll does seem to be accepted broadly, but of course this is something that is up to you to really make the best decision based on who you're targeting and your site needs. Now, this does affect the default text on the browser, because the text is dynamic. So let's say we were to remove consent on scroll. You will notice that the text gets shorter because it removes the part that refers to consent by scroll being a way of giving consent. All right, and if you put that back in, you'll see that it's now added here. So it says you agree to use of cookies by scrolling your page. And if we completely remove consent by continued browsing, it completely removes that section and it only registers consent when the person closes the banner. Now, let's get into the exciting stuff. We're going to go into the advanced view, and this opens up so many options, a host of customizations that allow you to not only change the behavior of the banner, but also change the look. And that's what we're going to be doing today. So we're going to just jump right ahead down to appearance. Now, under appearance, you can see the defaults are written here. So it's highlighted as custom, but this is what is default. So if we were to switch to default, this wouldn't change. All right, so the default is a black background and the white text. Now let's just go back into custom really quickly and let's change a couple of things. Now let's say we wanted to have a really exciting color, so we want to go with orange. We just simply write in orange, and it takes us to a basic default orange Okay, so these sections allow you to modify the look of the banner as you would using HTML and CSS. All right, so with that in mind, if we wanted to get a specific shade of orange, we didn't just want to use the default, you could very easily here just put in some hex code. And now we have burnt orange. And the same thing applies to this section here. So you can just write in the color, or you can put hex or RGB code in here to change the look of the banner. Now just scrolling down, we can do some other fun things like change the font size. So let's say we just want to make this a little bit smaller. We can just put in pixels, or you can put in, for example, EM. So you have a lot of options here. Or you can just completely leave it as the default. It's up to you. Also, you can modify the size of the close button. So let's say we wanted to make that a little bit smaller. So we can change the size of that. We can make it bigger. But quite excitingly, something else that we can do is we can completely change the icon. So let's say I wanted to change my icon to a custom image or something like that. You can just very easily do that using some HTML image text. And I've already copied it to my clipboard, so I'm just going to go ahead and just paste that in there. And you can see the close button has now been changed to an actual image. So you have a lot of options for customization. Another thing that you can do that's quite useful is you can also modify the, let's just go ahead and find that, the cookie policy linked text. So let's say instead of cookie policy, you wanted to say cookie notice. You could do that very easily right there. And let's say you wanted to completely change the banner content. You could write whatever you wanted to write there and completely change the entire banner text. You could also put in HTML and CSS here to style the text how you want in case that's what you wanted to do. So for example, you could just copy the banner text and then style it in various ways. You have a lot of options here to play with it. You can fully style the banner. Now, you'd want to just be really careful here because there are certain things that you need to say legally by default in informing people about your use of cookies. So if you are modifying the text, do keep in mind making sure that your disclosures are compliant. So you might want to model the text if you do decide to change it after what we have written here. Other than that, you can change some other things in regards to the banner. You can, as I mentioned, you can change the HTML here. You can add in CSS styles here. So add a custom here completely removes the styles that were added. And this allows you to completely add your own styles. You can change the shape, the look, the layout, the location, all of these things using these options. Okay, so that brings us to the end of this short customization video. Once again, as you can see, there are so many options. You even have sections where you can add JavaScripts. You can edit and add various callbacks, things like that. And once again, we do have guides, very detailed guides with all of this information, all the tutorials telling you how to make changes here. So, and if you do have a lot of, if you find it difficult to figure out how to do that, you can always reach out to our customer support at any time and we will help you through it.